stepping away from the run on UFO and cryptid themed videos for just a moment, and I periodically cover technology and societal changes, especially when these changes may see us morph into a new type of species. One of these developments has just come to light with the publishing of a planned military program to create cybernetic soldiers. This really is an idea that is being pushed down our throats of late, a real push by science fiction books, TV and film, which you could almost see as some kind of marketing campaign. Upgrade today, make all your problems go away. However, it never works out well for the characters in these stories, so what makes the United States Army think they can do better? Let's take a look. Welcome to IF, videos on history, mystery, and the strange. Hit that subscribe button and ring the bell so you never miss a video again. The BBC recently published a story on their Asian news network about America's plan to create super soldiers. Far from using some magic potion like we see in the comics with Captain America, these advanced warriors will be built using the latest in technology. They will be the world's first cyborg soldiers. The Combat Capability Development, CCDC, headquarters of the United States Army, says that they are currently in development of technology that will enhance the vision, hearing, and muscle performance of American troops. They envision the completion of this plan sometime around 2050. As a rule of thumb, we can see that, on average, a military research program is normally 25 years ahead of what they allow the public to know. This would give us a much sooner date of 2025 for the coming of these cybernetic soldiers. The CCDC published a report which was titled Cyborg Soldiers 2050, Combining Humans and Machines. US Department of Defense has identified four areas of biotechnology that has been evaluated which should be available to human soldiers within the next 30 years. These include the enhancement of eyes, ears, and muscles. They are going to give these men and women abilities that, until now, have been firmly in the realms of fiction. Like Steve Austin, the $6 million man, these people will be built, and this raises all sorts of ethical questions. The team researching this technology stated that the creation of a cyborg warrior with superhuman abilities, especially the direct enhancement of the nervous system in the brain, will lead to a strategic revolution, implementing a truly modern battle plan. Creating networked people working as a single super unit and possessing abilities far beyond any natural man or woman. Have they not considered what will happen to these cyborgs after their service? How will they integrate back into regular society with the super abilities gifted to them by the military? It is already difficult enough for servicemen and women to build a life after the military. Also, what threat do they see coming, or what do they have planned for there to be such a need to create super cybernetic troops? Surely, if we are advancing to such capabilities, would it not be better to build superhumans that could survive the rigors of space? That way, we could set out and find another planet and more resources, a benefit to all, not just those that want to fight. After all, most conflicts are over resources, so the abundant opportunities found in the stars could help bring an end to fighting here on Earth. What if these troops decide that they no longer want to take orders? Will they turn on us, or is there an off switch that those in charge can flick? If there is a switch, then we are into another set of ethical questions. This is shaky ground at best, but I think it's something that will become prevalent. The future may just be a mirror of what is seen in Alita: Battle Angel. They may not be creating the hulking cybernetic assassins of that comic book and movie, but they are definitely starting down that path. The first stage is the creation of devices that will improve senses. As always, the case is that this technology is being marketed as an aid to those with disabilities. Cyborg ears have already been designed and built. They not only help change the lives of hundreds of thousands of hearing impaired people, but also helps change the way people can hear. If you were to choose, you could have your hearing augmented. The designers have now turned their attention to the human eye. Google recently released images of a device which can be worn like a contact lens and gives the wearer bionic vision. The eyes of the cyborg warrior will be able to see and create enlarged images clearly. This improves vigilance and awareness of the surrounding situation, a must for a soldier. The ears of the cyborg help with communication and detection systems. Hearing being boosted to be so effective, a whisper can become a shout. These mechanical systems will be combined with genetics. The techniques of optical genetics, optogenetics, use genetic engineering to allow light-sensitive molecules to control the activities within the cell wall. This could give a person the ability to have natural night vision or see in different light spectrums. The program will also improve on the body's capabilities. The muscles of the cyborg warrior will be made stronger and quicker. First, through the wearing of a bodysuit, an exosuit with enhanced strength and reactions. This will kick off a new arms race, and we are seeing the first tit-for-tat developments of this new technology. Russia has been busy building its own Iron Man armor for military use. And as we mentioned, the ironclad warrior of Marvel fame, something else that these new suits will have in common with the comic book hero, is that they will enable the soldier to communicate and share data directly to machines. They will also have the ability, through these upgrades, that will allow direct brain-to-brain communication between humans and humans. How could this possibly go wrong? Not only will these cyborgs be a formidable physical presence, they will also be silent, communicating through a single neural grid. Do we really want to unleash such a formidable foe? These cyborg soldiers will also communicate directly with unmanned vehicles and directly control various automated weapon systems. This, the developers say, will make command and combat operations much more efficient. So, we may not only be facing these advanced cyborgs, we may also have to deal with their robot backup. Aside from military technology, the report also points out that cyborg applications will also be widespread in civil society over the next 30 years. It singles out the use of cybernetics in health facilities, the economic value of cyborg technology in civil society, and how it will continue to increase and be a driving force for the development of a new society. All this originating with these military cyborgs. They really do want a post-human future. The report is not all happiness and digital sunshine. It concludes with its concerns for the future, outlining how cyborg technology and creating human enhancement is gaining in popularity among the general public. This could result in an imbalance and social inequality, which in turn could lead to legal, security, and more ethical issues. A final, startling line in the report says that robots will replace 20 million factory workers by the year 2030. So maybe the biggest weapon they have to wipe out the non-cybernetic will be economics. So what do you think of this cybernetic future? Will you be willing to take an upgrade? Or will you stand against this technological evolution of the human species? Let me know in the comments below. Before I go, I would like to give a shout out to the Venomous Fringe. Check out their channel for some interesting podcasts and to hear channel supporter and friend Ryan Tremblay's take on such topics as Bigfoot, Dogman, and other cryptids. As always, if you like what I do here on the channel, hit that red button, like, and share. You can catch the latest by searching We Are If. Thanks so much for watching. Merry Christmas. I'll see you next time.